Scrappers, it's Monica with Scrapping for My Voice. I'm here to do a quick little video. Sorry, my voice is all off. It's really early in the morning. I did a mini album as a thank you gift for my son's teacher, since he's going to be finishing kindergarten. I didn't have too much time to work on this. I think I only spent like maybe 2 hours at the most. I'm not really happy with the way it came out, but I made a decision a long time ago that I was going to do a video for every single project that I finished, whether I liked it or not. And this is my first Chipboard finished album. It was originally supposed to be 5 pages, but I just didn't have time to, you know, complete it, so I only did 4. And it's really basic. There's not much embellishing, not much, you know, stuff inside. It's just pretty basic. This is one of the Chipboard albums from Michaels. I believe they're from the dollar section, $1.50. So I used a paper line that I don't like. I used the K&Co faded Lotus collection by Amy Butler. And it's just, you know, it was too flowery and the colors really weren't my thing, so I did the best of what I could. So I used a ribbon binding, which is not bad. I probably would have opted for something else, but, you know, last minute, this is what I got. So I have some of this pleated ruffle tulle trim that I showed on my cigar box. I used a strip along the bottom, along with some silver mesh bling. Then we have a cut from my Spellbinders. I believe this is labels. Well, what labels is this? 4? 9? One of the two. Then I used a Chipboard alpha from, let's see if I can track it down. Oh, I have no idea what it is, but I'll put what it was in the little box below. I used some Wild Orchid Crafts. I have the trellis rose here, this lime green and yellow cherry blossom. I used some of the rose's leaves, and I can't remember the size. These are from I'm Roses, but once again, I'll put the item right here in the little box on the screen. We have a 1.5-inch wild rose, and two of these are the little open rosebuds. Well, they're not buds. The little open roses are the small ones. I believe they're like 1/4-inch wide. This one I colored in Lindy Stamping in Silent Night Silver. And this one here, the black one, was colored by, you probably can't see the label, but Midnight Rendezvous Raven. I use Black Recollections Bling here, and I used, around the little label, I just use the Studio G glitter. This is one of the Sweetheart Blossoms, which I also colored in the Silent Night Silver. So if you open it, here's the first page. I used 10mm flatback pearls here. The stamp is from K&Co. I don't remember the name of the stamp set. We have some trim from Hobby Lobby here. I just made a pocket. There's 2 tags inside. And I didn't really put too much room for journaling because, you know, she's not really going to be journaling, so it's really not that big of a deal. I'll just stand these in there. Over here, the next page, as you can see, they're all really plain. Have this flips up. And then it flips down. So she's got plenty of room for photos in here. And as you can see, the paper's really loud. Some more flatback pearls here. I'm trying to go through this fast. I gotta get ready for work, so. Here's just a plain photo mat. Some lime green mesh bling. Here is a flourish. This is a Spellbinders flourish, which, from the Fanciful Flourish. Here we have a gardenia, and these were all the loose petals. I used three of the bigger pieces and one of the small ones, and then I use a flat back pearl inside. And then you see a leaf here. On this one, you just have a plain pocket page. I use the Tim Holtz Flourish larger one, and I colored it with Franken Lime Green. Well, sorry, Freaky Franken Lime, I should say. And then while it was still wet, where is that? While it was still wet, instead of using embossing powder, I just I used the stain, and then I sprinkled some of the Pearl Pesto Recollections embossing powder, and it kind of just gave it didn't emboss it everything, it just kind of gave it like a little wet, like a little wet beaded water look. If, you know, you can't really see it, but I used a pink cherry blossom, a silver 2-inch butterfly, nylon butterfly, another one of the little open roses. These are I Am Roses Puffy Daisies, and I used three layers with a ribbon buckle and a black flat back pearl in the center. And this is just a plain library pocket. I lined the edge of the entire thing with silver paint, and I used my 1-inch circle punch here. And this, basically, I didn't really do any tags. This is just a regular plain old photo mat. And I only did one since I didn't really make the pocket to be expandable. This is just meant to be a small album to hold a few photos. It's not like she's trying to keep her life story in here. And here is the last two pages. I just did a regular pocket here. We've got some black lace and some black flatback pearls. This is the chrysanthemums from Waldorf Crafts. We got a 1-inch nylon silver butterfly. I used the Martha Stewart Deco Fan Punch here. And I put two photo mats there, front and back. As you can see, I told you I was going to leave it really simple and plain. And this is the last page here. I used three flat flowers and some black flatback pearls. And this is the only page where, you know, you actually see pink on the paper. So I just decided to use these pink flat flowers. And this is just a flap that opens up to reveal two more photo mats. And that's it. That is the plain little mini album that I did. Once again, it's not anything I'm too particularly proud of, but it is what it is. Oh, and I forgot to mention, I did ink all the edges with the black soot Destruct Sink. So since this was a rush, and I only really spent, you know, 2 hours on it or so, I would say maybe three at the most, and most of it was spent covering, you know, cutting paper and covering it and coloring flowers. But it is what it is, and hopefully my next one will come out much, much better. So thanks so much for watching. There will be some still shots of the mini right after this video, so you can go ahead and stay tuned and see some clear pictures. Thanks again, and go ahead and leave your comments. But yeah, this paper line, not my cup of tea, so I had a really hard time thinking about how I wanted to embellish it in the first place, so... The cover I like. The cover came out nice. And that's probably all I'll say about that. So, well, thanks again. I'll talk to you later. Bye.